Hello and welcome to this video. In the past months, I've seen posts with wrong information about the compatibility of the LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor set and the powered up hardware. So I thought it's time to make a video on how to use the stuff that's compatible with the coding blocks for the Robot Inventor Hub. And in this case, it's not really the Robot Inventor Hub, but my Robot Inventor Hub is built in another project. So I use the Spec Prime Hub, but it's exactly the same. And I use the Robot Inventor software. And first of all, let's talk about the pretty obvious things. Oh, and it's only for these code blocks. I won't cover the compatibility in Python in this video because you can use everything with Python. It just might not be straightforward. But now let's start. Obviously, the official parts are compatible. So the Robot Inventor comes with a distance sensor. So that's compatible. The color sensor is compatible. And the angular motor is compatible. The XL motor is compatible as well, or the large angular motor. And the other control plus motors work as well, because they're pretty similar to the other motors, to the angular motors. Then we have this sensor. It comes with the Spike Prime set, but it doesn't come with the Robot Inventor set, and currently there's no coding block for the sensor. So it works with the hub. It's meant to work with the hub, but there's no coding blocks for that. These sensors don't work either with the hub because there are no coding blocks. And that leaves us with these three motors and the lights. And they're a bit special. So let's talk about these three motors first. In the software, there's the option to set the speed of the motor. So we can use this block to control how fast the motor moves, but it actually checks if the motor is fast enough, and it will get faster if it's too slow, or it will give more power if it's too slow, or it will give less power if it's too fast. So it basically checks the actual speed of the motor. However, that only works with motors that have a speed sensor. So it only works with this motor or with this motor, and not with motors that don't have speed sensors. So it doesn't work with lights because lights don't have speed sensors. That wouldn't make sense. And it doesn't work with both of these motors. But that's not really a problem because we have additional blocks. We can open them here and then we can add more blocks or more motor blocks. And here we have the option to control the power of the motor. So we can control the speed, and then the motor checks if it's actually that fast, and it will give more power if it isn't fast enough. And we have the power where we control the power directly, and we don't have a feedback of how fast the motor is. So you can stop the motor with your hand, and the program won't notice that. But let me write a test application. And of course, we can move the motor for a certain amount of degrees, the one that's controlled by a power, because it can't measure the degrees. So this is my test program. I want to move the motor with a given power. If I press the left button, and for one rotation, if I press the right button. It's a pretty simple program. So let's check it out. And first, let me show an official motor. I have to plug it into port A. And I can press the left button, then it rotates with a power of 100%, and I can move it for a certain amount of rotations. So this motor works with both commands. I can also show this program so that you know the right button for the right case. Left is power, right is rotation. So let's use the medium motor, or the simple medium motor, or the simple linear motor. We can use the power command and it works just fine, but it doesn't move if we want to control the rotation because it can't measure the rotations. Same for the train motor. I hope that you can see the rotation. It only rotates with the left button. You can use the powered up lights as well. They work just fine with the power command. And now to this motor from the LEGO Boost set, so the medium linear motor. It can move with power and it can move for rotations, but it still lacks a bit of functionality of the other motors. This motor has a rotation sensor, but it doesn't have an absolute position. What does that mean? This motor has a mark. It can always detect its zero position, so it can always get back to this position, or it knows how far it moved from that position. We can start the motor here, and it will still know that this would be the zero position. So this has an actual or a zero position that it keeps in mind even if you turn the hubs off. Same for these motors, they have a mark as well. And the Control Plus motors, they don't have a mark, but they have the same functionality, so they know their position even if you turn the hub off. But this one doesn't have an absolute position, but only a relative position. So it won't keep the position after you turn the hub off, but it can measure the current position and the current speed. There are actually extra blocks for the relative position, and you can access them with the additional motor blocks as well. So here you can set the relative position and you can get it. But that was it for this video. I hope that it helped you, that now you might understand what you can use with the Robot Inventor set and what you can't use. Thanks for watching. Feel free to ask me any questions that you've got in the comments. See you in the next video and bye.